is the Lorraine 155-51. This is a French Tier 8 SPG, and the map is Epic Normandy in the frontline game. So I haven't played enough SPG to know all the great positions, but we're going to find out. I did find a new sniping position today on a resupply facility on the map, Craftworks. It's basically in the upper northwest corner. You can snipe on the resupply facility from a little bush pretty far away. It's pretty cool. And there's some hull down positions. So you can see the enemy didn't come out, which is not a good sign. They're playing like a bunch of noobs. And it looks like somebody has already left the flank. I am a strong believer in blind firing. Oh, they did come out. We just didn't see them because they're invisible. Nice hit. That was 190 damage. SPG used to be very powerful, but now it is heavily nerfed. So anyone who complains about SPG, you really have no reason to complain. It used to be so powerful. You would get top damage every game. You would one-shot everything. And it was very destructive. But it's not that way anymore. Now you've got a long reload, and you only do a little bit of damage. Like, I only did 38 damage on that shot. And it's hard to have an impact on the game. But before, I mean, even if you were a mediocre SPG player, it was very, very strong tank. These guys obviously are a bunch of numbnuts. They don't know what they're doing. Unfortunately, I did not take up a good position. That's all part of learning. So I'm going to take up a better position. I think I'm going to go this way. Ready to fire. See, my allies are amazing, which is why they're on that cap already. I thought I saw a tank right there. I gotta take another look at that. I thought I saw a low hit point tank right there. I guess I was wrong. You know, there's a chance I might just park over here. Let's see what happens. It's like we got some girls over here. There is a little bit of frame dropped issues with frame loss. Not sure what's causing it yet. Got 211 damage on the 7032. These guys need my help, so I'll help them out. I don't know what those little flags are over the tanks, but obviously I do see them. And it hasn't really been explained. I'm sure somebody knows.
The flags mean that that's a special tank. And if you don't know that, then you don't know anything about the game. Everybody knows what the flag is.
Come on. That was a wasted shot. Yeah, so sometimes tags have flags over them and they change colors, all sorts of pretty colors. And I never saw anybody say what it was. You can see that my Unicum teammates over here are going around the far side instead of getting on the cap. That was 267 damage on the IS-3. I've only done 1,000 damage. It's not easy to do damage in this game. You know what? You want to get the mini-map scaled out so you can really see what's going on. There have been games where I could have reset cap, but I forgot to see what was going on. I didn't know the enemy was capping. 237 damage on the IS-3. He's so smart, he's just going to sit there. Oh, we got two knuckleheads. Lance and C and a Burrask. Up to 1,200 damage. Well deserved. Line shot. It sucks. Really doesn't matter what flank you're helping, as long as you're helping somebody. Over here, I've got two targets I could potentially hit, so I'm going to go for the two that are closer together. Easier for me to keep an eye on what's going on. I might miss one and hit the other, which does happen. Wow, look how long it took for that shot to go in. I only did 40 damage, which means it was a complete waste of time. Okay, so he's at a very distant range. He's at 1,000 meters. I have to take account for the time it takes for the shell to arrive. This guy's obviously a knucklehead. He's going to park right there. I think one of his allies is over here. No, but he's a faster tank. Yeah, I missed him. It might be possible I might have to go for the tanks that are closer so I can increase the chance that I hit them. And the whole purpose is to actually hit the tanks. I've only got 16 rounds left, which means there is a real chance I might run out of ammo. You know what? I think I'm going to change my strategy and go for the tanks that are in my neighborhood. I like to play. No, I don't want to say something that is a joke that could be censored by the man. But it was a joke that had to do with the word play and the word neighborhood. Wow, they actually pulled it off. Got some stun damage, up to 1,400 damage, 1,189 stun damage. These girls might need some help at the A cap. You know what? This is not good. I've got an issue with my reticle. So I'm going to switch caps. The issue of what's going to happen at B is the enemy is going to leave, except for the knucklehead, who is too dumb to leave, which is that Udis right there. Has the dumb gene. He's about to be pummeled. He's got to be a new player. He must not know any better. Yeah, just reloaded. Say hello. I guess I hit him, or maybe it was my ally. No, I didn't hit him. Okay, so I'm going to take this time to go to the resupply facility, and I'm going to do some resupplying. Did I not fire? I mean, it says 25-second reload. Maybe I didn't fire. What do you got, buddy? Lots of time. Lots of time. You're going to be happy real soon. You're going to be happy with that position. It's very hard to aim accurately because of the distance, and in that case, there was a little bit of a slope. So I was more concerned about getting over that slope, and if I had adjusted more accurately to where he was reversing to, I might have ended up misadjusting for the slope, which would be bad. Bad. So that's 120 damage. I'm not doing that great. I'm only up to Sergeant Jane Cool. Really got to do a lot more, but I'm going to help these guys advance because they obviously can't do it themselves. I don't want to sit on the cap, so I got to get off the cap. The reason why I'm sitting here is I'm actually playing with one hand because my hand hurts, which is the reality of SPG players, constant one-hand hurting syndrome. Scorpion G, with his amazing Scorpion G armor, missed. I think he's warpacking. He's obviously warpacking.
All he's doing is complaining about people warpacking.
LT-432. See how good you are. You're that good. Look at how he avoided that shot. Knows what he's doing. Oh, it would be so nice if I could hit these guys, but we've got that amazing Unicum positioning. Okay, so I will help out on Cap A because obviously they're a bunch of knuckleheads. They don't know what they're doing. 5 minutes remaining. 5 minutes of torture. Look how long it takes for that. Did the shot even come in? Okay, so I'm guessing that the shot never arrived. There must be something in the way in front of me. SU-130PM. Meter shot, 58 damage. Come on. Gotta be a lot more productive. Shot. Okay, 46 damage. Obviously, that's a waste. Very slow game. There's 3.5 minutes left. Very difficult to play SPG. I've heard that it's very easy to level up and get general with SPG. I believe you have to be on the defending team and just keep resetting the cap. Damage. Not much. Again, he's warpacking. Okay, he's going to be an easy shot, so I'm going to keep on going after him. So there's a way you can aim on the minimap. You click control, and then you click the right mouse button, and it will re-aim your SPG. 1,700 damage, not doing so good in terms of the damage total, or in terms of stun damage. But I really want to help them cap A, so we're going to forget about the other caps. We're going to work on A, because I don't have anybody near E. And it does look like they are going after F. Testing it, shall we say. Not being very supportive from my team. I really need to get a better position. I have some ideas. I'm starting to think that what I should have done was just gone into A. I mean, doesn't that make sense? If I had gone into A, my shots would get there a lot quicker. Come on, I need this. I should have done something. I am going to head towards A. Which means I might miss my chance to fire. Let's see what we got here. Nothing. Centurion. Rain. So I'm going to start coming out a little bit. I feel closeted over here. See the amazing engine power. about the Lorraine. 5 minutes. Tiger one. Look at that amazing reverse speed. Better hit him. I guess I missed. So I just assumed that he was going to start heading in the other direction. It looks like he didn't. Defender. It's going to be a low damage game for me. Even though I'm spotted, it's not that big of a deal because the enemy has so many targets. I'm not going to pop up in front of him. Figured that would happen. Centurion. Wow, it's so difficult to climb in damage. When I play heavy tanks, I actually do good. I do really swell with the heavy tanks. I get a decent amount of damage. Well, actually, I hit him for 321. That's pretty cool. I'm going to go for the turtle. The turtles tend to not move. They like to be in one spot because they also are invisible all the time. So I'm likely to hit the turtle. .286 damage. That's pretty good. My team has no idea how to play. So I might blind fire over here. I got 10 rounds left, which means I am going to have to go and resupply soon. Look at the distance that turtle made. Went all the way back to there, but it won't be enough because he sucks. So I hit him for 172, and I'm going to try and hit him again. Blind fire over here if I have to. Come on, spot him. Be really useful if you could spot him. Nice, 245. Got 8 shots left. 2100 stun, 2800 damage. I might have gotten a little bit more damage in the game because there were some blind shots, but don't expect much. Ah! I pushed the button by mistake, which means I'm probably not going to get any damage. I'm going to take a chance with the resupply facility. T26E5, his armor is not that great. I should be able to get something against him. Come on. There you go. Go. Ah! So right when I fired, he changed direction. So he cheated me. He's obviously poor packing. Good thing about playing SPG is you are a lot more aware of what's going on in the game. Last chance to capture. focus on D. And I'm going to head into D, help these losers. .290 stun damage on the T-54 Mod 1. I'm going to go after these TDs up here. 1,300 meters. They are at the edge of my range. Okay, so I'm going to take a chance that they are going to start capping E. And I'm going to keep on moving closer. Oh, M44. M40. That's closer. But nice if I took him out of the game. Let's see if we can hit these losers. Well, at least they destroyed something. Looks like that Oho might be AFK, so I was able to get a nice shot on him. For an amazing 88 damage. Up to 2,900 damage. I think I'm going to be able to level up to whatever's after Sergeant. I believe it's going to be Lieutenant. And this Oho, he's a really good player. I see how he's aiming his gun very carefully directly in front of him. Oh, it sucks. I got cheated. Really want to level up. I got maybe one more shot left in the game. This could be it. Hit him for 190. Got up to Lieutenant. Lost the game. 3,100 damage, 2,700 stun. Yeah, it was difficult. Wasn't easy. Unfortunately, you don't get to pick if you're attacking or defending. You are going to level up faster defending because of resetting cap. I think there is something else where if you hit somebody and they're near the final objective, you get extra EXP. I'm really not sure. Lieutenant. I'm going to leave the platoon. Because I like to obviously look around at what's going on. Wow. Look at this loser. He's name shaming me. That's 3,500 damage, 2,700 stun.